What is up, YouTube? Vats here, bringing you guys the first set of games from Top 4. We're going up against Jahiroat, and I don't remember his last name, but it's Jahiroat. This is the guy who got top 8 at the Portland, Oregon Regionals. He's using the exact same team with the same Scarf Arcanine, Porygon 2, Muk, and what is that, Zerkatry? He also had Feeny and I think Garchomp, but I don't remember his last mon. I did play against him in Swiss of the tournament before he made top cut, and I actually did beat him in Swiss, so I know pretty much everything there is to know about his team, and I've already beaten it once before. This time, though, I'm gonna be using a different team, you know, the team you've been seeing me use all throughout this tournament, because, like I said, this is a different tournament. We're gonna be using Sash Butterfree, we're gonna be using that bulky Arcanine, we're gonna be using Life Orb Lele and Z Move Garchomp. So I just wanna start this one off, get right into it, and talk a little bit about how my team handles the matchup, especially like the Feeny matchup. You see, he didn't really bring Feeny in this game, but, you know, I did bring the correct Pokemon just in case he did. And remember, like I said, he is using that juicy Scarf Arcanine. So the Scarf Arcanine is loosely what his team is based around. It looks like it's like a Trick Room team, but it's just actually a bunch of support Pokemon that are supporting his Scarf Arcanine and really letting that Pokemon shine. So you can see my Butterfree and Arcanine are going to be leading off against his Arcanine and Porygon, and what I wanted to do was lead with a really slow Pokemon that I could switch out in case he wanted to switch in a Feeny, because remember, when you switch Pokemon, switching is based off speed tiering, so since most of his Pokemon are faster than mine, he'd be switching out first if he decided to switch out in the first place. So since he's not switching out, it's just going to let me switch in my Lele, and remember, you have to switch in a Tapu to change terrain. So I expected him to switch in Feeny. I expected him to like switch out the Arcanine for Feeny and try to set up a Trick Room. He decides just to switch out the Porygon for Muk and just go for a Flare Blitz onto the Butterfree slots. So looks like he's just testing my team right now, testing to see if I have a Focus Sash, which of course I have a Focus Sash on the Butterfree for this tournament. You guys have seen it before. So he's gonna take a bunch of recoil, and Sleep Powder is gonna come in on the Muk. So looks like there's no Feeny. We've seen three of his Pokemon. Remember, he does have the Zerkatry, but at this time in the game, I don't really know that he has a Zerkatry. So he's gonna be withdrawing the Arcanine, and he's gonna be coming back in with the Porygon. I think it's a pretty good play. You know, it's pretty obvious, but there's not really that much that an intimidated Arcanine can do against a Lele in this scenario. So I'm gonna be switching out my Butterfree. Remember, that guy doesn't have Protect, and I don't really want to just let it go down to Arcanine, so I'm gonna switch in Garchomp on that slot and go for a Psychic on what was the original Arcanine slot. So it deals a little bit over half because Life Orb Lele is a monster, and as you can see here, I'm in a dominating position. You know, Garchomp can check the Muk, Lele can check the Porygon, I feel like I'm in a really good spot. And when, you know, when you're in a really good spot, what you want to do is you want to push that advantage even further. You know, like I said, I could have just went for the Z move on the Muk, but I realized he was probably going to be switching in the Arcanine in on one of the slots, and I can just go for a Swords Dance. You know, I get intimidated. It's really no big deal. I just pop the Swords Dance, go back up to plus one. Psychic's going to finish off that Arcanine, and then from here he has Mystery Pokemon in the back, which we can assume is not Feeny. We have an Asleep Muk, and we have the Porygon, who's at less than half. So at this point in the game, you know, it's pretty much over. He realized the way I wanted to play my leads against his team, and you know, he can kind of try to clean it up a little bit for game two, because he still has, at this point, hasn't really seen Tauntaun Lele or anything like that. But you know, there's not really that much he can do. It's probably best for him just to try and scoop the game right there and try and preserve, you know, a little bit of what he was trying to do. And you know, I'm totally fine taking game one in that regard. I legit just won that game one because I knew a lot about his team from the best of three that we played before. So we're gonna be going into game two. We're gonna see if he can clean up his act a little bit and probably bring Feeny. Alright, so looking at the teams for game two, you see that he decided to put in Feeny instead of Zerkatry, and I brought the same four. I'm like, well, this totally worked for me. I'm just gonna continue to do this. And, you know, I should be fine, because like I said, I feel that my team has a very good matchup against teams like his on paper. You know, Garchomp, Swords Dance Garchomp in particular, kind of just runs through this team if you deny them their Trick Room. So we're gonna hop right into game two. And I did make a mistake. I decided to bring the same four Pokemon, but I brought them not in the same order. I realized he probably didn't want to bring Feeny for some reason, so there must be a reason why. And this game, he decides to lead the exact same way, but I've kind of led a little bit differently. I decided to lead Lele and Butterfree. And in leading Lele and Butterfree, I can't do the same switch out play at the same speed tiering that I could before. And also, I'm a little bit more susceptible to just taking a bunch of damage, or like a Muk switch in just totally having too much pressure on me. Like, let's say if I were to psychic something and he switched into Muk to block that, I have two Pokemon that are potentially bodied by that Muk, because I can't really put it to sleep because I don't know if he's going to switch Aphinia on the other slot, and then Muk just has a ton of offensive pressure in that situation. So you see, I decided to switch out Butterfree because I really think that he's going to be switching in Aphinia, and you see that the Aphinia does switch in. So first turn, we're just switching everything around, and remember, like I said, he still has that Scarf Arcanine, who luckily I intimidate this turn. But, you know, Scarf Arcanine's really, really good, and he does really base his playstyle around that Scarf Arcanine. So Arcanine is going to chunk my Lele for just a ton of damage as I come in with a taunt. And you can see right away from turn one, I don't have any other Tapu I can switch in to regain Tapu control, and my Tapu's threatened by his Arcanine. So I have to switch out Lele in for Garchomp, which isn't really a terrible play. But remember, you don't really ever just want to switch in Garchomp on a board where Aphinia, who is taunted, has to attack every turn. I'm going to be eating Muddy Waters. I'm going to be eating Moon Blasters. A bunch of damage is going to be coming my way through the next few turns before I can even attack or do anything like that. So Arcanine's taking a bunch of damage from recoil. My Arcanine's going to reply back with a Wild Charge that's going to be super effective as I take a little bit of recoil of my own, and we're going to see the Feeny start slamming these Muddy Waters into me. And Muddy Water isn't super effective against Garchomp, but it still does a decent amount, so it's something I have to watch out for as the series goes on. So Feeny's gonna restore a little bit with leftovers. I think it puts it right out of range from like a high-end wild charge, which kind of matters in this matchup. So we're gonna see him withdraw his Arcanine, coming in with Porygon. And remember, you may think that this is a bad play from me. You may think like, wow, why would you do this play? You probably could have just won. I'm gonna withdraw my Arcanine, right? I'm gonna withdraw in Arcanine because I wanna try to use Butterfree. I think Butterfree is the correct play here. And I'm gonna go for a Tech Rage on what was the Arcanine slot. And you may be thinking, why are you hitting the Arcanine slot? You know, you gotta get rid of that Feeny, man. And the Feeny couldn't even protect. Why didn't you just get rid of the Feeny? To be honest, I feel like I could take out Feeny with Lele, or, you know, I could switch in Lele and sleep out of the Feeny. I feel that I could technically get away with ignoring Feeny, and I know that Arcanine is the Pokemon that he uses to win his games. So I decided to try and play around Arcanine. I really thought he was just going to switch the Feeny out. To be completely honest, I thought he was going to switch out the Feeny for the Porygon, and then if that's what happened, I would have had a great play because I just would have T-Rage that, and then next turn I would have just switched out my Garchomp slot for Lele and had, you know, just a great time, sleep powder and everything. So he read me reading him, and as it stands, it still looks like I'm in a good spot. You know, he can't take away the terrain, but I'm a Pokemon down, and my main sweeper is heavily damaged. So this is exactly what I was talking about. You know, Muk switching in and just having like a huge power play. Remember Feeny's taunt? I went away last turn, so yeah, he blocks my Psychic. I go for a Tailwind here, which is the correct play, because now I don't really have to be afraid of Scarf Arcanine anymore. But I mean, I'm really running out of ideas here, because that Muk just has a huge power play against me. I have Butterfree, a Lele that can't really do anything against it, and like a bulky Arcanine. So I'm running out of ideas. You see, he switches in his Porygon here, and he gets a useless downward proc. I think it's attack boost, yeah. As his Muk goes for a Protective Block of Sleep Powder, I'm pretty sure I Psychic the Porygon this turn. But even if I Psychic the Porygon, you're gonna see what happens here. It's not great for me because there's just not that much I can do if the Feeny terrain is the predominant terrain on the field in this matchup. So he blocks my Sleep Powder, which is the correct play, and then he sends his Feeny right back out. So as it stands, I have a Tailwind up. I have Speed Control. But his Pokemon are just too bulky, and I'm out of offensive options to be able to deal with this. I'm gonna do the best I can. I'm gonna go for Rage Powder and try and sweep some stuff up with my Lele. But, you know, I don't maybe Rage Powder wasn't the right play. Because you see, I go for the Psychic here, and it drops the Feeny quite low. And you see that I do get the special attack drop, which means I could have went for a Bug Buzz into that slot. But even if I did and I KO'd the Feeny, he probably just would have KO'd my Lele with the Muk. I think we're going to see Muk attack this turn, and then would have been Arcanine and Butterfree versus Muk and Arcanine, and it's not like a matchup I feel very confident in, because I can't really sleep powder anything. Like, Butterfree really doesn't do that much in this matchup. So you see, he totally played his terrains correctly, and he got me this time. But in all honesty, I went with somewhat of the same strategy as before because it worked so well. You know, I was like, well, if he's not used to playing against Butterfree, I was just gonna try and take advantage of that. Looks like he tightened everything up in all the correct ways, and he totally Waited me out and beat me in game two. So that was what happened in game two. We're going to be going into game three here, where I can try a couple other strats. That counter Feeny strat, if you will. So here is game three. I said I was going to give you guys the anti-Feeny strat. What he did that game was he tightened it up. He decided to switch in Feeny and bring Feeny a lot more often and switch it in two or three times that game to take away my terrains and make it so Butterfree couldn't really work. What we're going to do in this scenario is we're going to use Butterfree and then two Tafus. So two Tafus that have pretty good matchups against Feeny, I would say, and then my Z-move Garchomp. So anytime we see that Feeny come in, we're just going to be switching in a Tapu. Or if we see the Feeny and we're just going to try and KO it with our Tapu. And then once the Feeny's gone, there's nothing really left to stop our Butterfree from going off. So we're going into game three against Jurariwot. I totally butcher that guy's name every single time. I'm just going to call him Jura. But anyways, we're going into game three, and I do feel pretty confident because Feeny is a decent Pokemon. It's really good against Butterfree, but I have a whole team of Pokemon that have potential, like one-shot potential on that guy. So we're deciding to go with the exact same ways we went last game, but remember, if he switches in a Feeny this time, we have a second switch in of a Tapu to reactivate the terrain, and then we can just keep continually switching Tapus forever until Feeny's just gone. That is pretty much how we're going to be able to play this. So Porygon gets a download proc, Arcanine gets Intimidate, no really big deals there. He's gonna be switching out Arcanine. Remember, switching is based on speed tiering, so since that Choice Scarf Arcanine decided to switch, he's gonna be switching out first. So Feeny comes in first here, and remember I do know that he was gonna be switching out the Arcanine, so I decided to switch in my Bulu. So we have a really good turn one play. Lele is slower than Scarf Arcanine, which means it's gonna be able to switch in seconds. So I get my terrain on the board. We get a Sleep Powder on what was the Arcanine slot, and the reason you're thinking, wow, why are you Sleep Powdering the Arcanine? Because if anyone was gonna switch out, all right, even if he doesn't switch out the Porygon for the Feeny, the Arcanine slot is the one that needs to get taken care of because Arcanine is his main Pokemon and he knows it. And I know it. Everyone knows it. And I really don't really care if he gets a Trick Room up because I'm just going to put everything to sleep forever. You see, he goes for an Ice Beam on the Butterfree slot. It's not going to clock my Sash. It's not going to freeze me. And we are continually putting even more Pokemon to sleep. So now two of his four Pokemon are asleep. We've seen all four. And now we can continually just start slamming wood hammers or switching around and exerting that dominance. At this point, he's pretty much waiting out his own Trick Room, trying to wake up. And it's not the smartest way to play. You know, I probably could have sleep powdered the Porygon, but I really wanted to lock down his big damage dealers and just kind of ignore his walls. I'm gonna be ignoring this muck. I'm gonna be ignoring the Porygon and just slamming big attacks into everyone. So he goes for a knockoff. He said I was gonna switch out my Bulu, but I really don't have to switch out my Bulu. Butterfree did its job. It's time for the main damage dealers to come in here, and we're just gonna start slamming these big wood hammers into Porygon. Look how much damage that does. The wood hammer stabbed in the terrain does about 65% to Porygon, and he really thought I was gonna switch it out there. I'm sure he thought I was gonna switch in Kartana or something, but that's why he probably didn't go for the poison jab. But I'm totally scarfed, and he doesn't really know that I'm scarfed, so that's another good thing for me. So we're gonna decide to bring in Garchomp here. Garchomp is pretty good, and remember, the grassy terrain limits the power that Earthquake can do. It cuts the power of ground moves in half, but for some reason, it doesn't affect Z moves. So Garchomp really has nothing to fear. He's just gonna pop a Swords Dance in this guy's face. So we got a Swords Dance off. We got a Scarf Bulu versus the asleep Porygon with the expiring Trick Room. We see we're gonna KO the Porygon right here. I got nothing to fear. And he probably thought I was gonna switch out my Bulu again, which is why I ignored it. But in reality, I'm like, yo, if you KO my Bulu, I'm gonna destroy you because my Lele is gonna come in and then I'm gonna just have too much damage for you to be able to deal with. So we KO the Porygon. Everyone's restoring health with the help of the grassy terrain. And, you know, even if you were to come in with, like, let's say Feeny or Arcanine, I really feel that plus two Garchomp can just carry me from here. Like, a Swords Dance Garchomp is just so good against his team, in my opinion. So I think he still has a couple turns left of Trick Room. He's gonna go for a poison jab onto my Bulu, which is completely fine. Like, Bulu did its job. It changed the terrain, let me get my sleep powders up, it KO'd the Porygon. Feeny's asleep, and when Feeny's asleep, Garchomp will play. I'm popping a big Tech Rage. I'm pretty sure I'm targeting the Feeny slot. I'm correcting my mistakes from game two, and I just wanna get that guy off the board. and try and steamroll the game with the remainder of my sweeper. So Tectonic Rage is gonna come in. I don't really know what the role is on regular Tectonic Rage. Remember, this Garchomp is at +2, so I'm fairly confident that we're gonna be able to one-shot the Feeny, which we do one-shot it, so that's pretty good. MVP to sleep as the dimensions return to normal just in time for Tapu Lele. Actually, it probably would have been better for us if dimensions hadn't returned back to normal, but remember, we do have a Garchomp on the board, and we're going to be trying to hit him with the oldest trick in the book. He's going to get a pretty juicy Intimidate off, but it's a little bit too late, I think. So Psychic Surge is going to activate, and I'm actually happy to see that, so he can't go for potential like Shadow Sneaks or E-Speeds onto my Garchomp. We're going to hit him with the oldest trick in the book, though. We're going to go with the Protect, and we're going to see him attack with the Arcanine. He's going for the only correct play. You may think, why is he Flare Blitzing a Garchomp? The correct play here is to burn Garchomp, and I'm really happy to see that he made the correct play in this scenario, but he doesn't get it. So he takes Recoil, he takes Rough Skin damage, and it's going to let me slam a huge +1 Earthquake into these two Pokemon that take super effective damage from my Earthquake. So we're going to be slamming that in, and we are going to pick up a double KO and have our Tapu Lele avoid all damage. So pretty good stuff there. I pretty much just tightened it up myself, brought two different Tapus, and played really, really aggressive. He went for a couple deep reads trying to ignore my Bulu, while my Bulu just went to town. I slammed like three or four wood hammers into stuff that game, and any time where you just let that stuff happen, it's not gonna end well. So pretty good games. Let me know what you guys think about them in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Next time is gonna be the finals. I'm gonna be going up against, what is this guy's name? This guy's name is TJ. Not the Pokémon player, but he has a pretty juicy Celesteela set. So stay tuned for the next episode, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.